Okay, hi, I'm Eloy from Winter Modular. We only have one model, the Eloquencer. It's an 8-track sequencer. It's based on the principle of 8-track control chain sequencer. That means, well, of course, that it has 8 tracks with gate and CV, and it's like a classical sequencer, but also it has some kind of probability and things that can make your sequence more like life. This is the new version, it's the silver version. And well, as you can see, you have 8 tracks with gate and CV output. And then here you have the step mode editions. That means that you can edit, for example, the CV. You press the step and you can press 3 steps at a time and change, or you can press the track and change all the time. You also can activate or deactivate gates, gate length. But you can change the gate length of every step per separate, and you also have ratcheting to the triplets and doublets and things like that. This is the first layer. Then you have a second layer when you can control the probability. So if you have chosen a note here in CV, if you go to the second layer, you can change the probability that you have a different note, and this note will take place within a range. So in the third layer, you change the range with it. This CV will take, well, we will change, vamos. Then the same for gate, you can change probability for all gates. The same for gate length, you can change probability for gate length and the random and the range within this probability will take place. Then, same for ratcheting. Then the thing is, let me... Okay. Then the thing is, you can change tempo, shuffle, scale. Here you can see there's a small keyboard with do, re, mi, fa, sol, and then you can choose the scale at the root, and also you can have an user scale, so you can activate or deactivate the notes in your scale to have your own scale. Step mode, if it goes forward or back, or backward, or pendle, randomly. You can activate this for all the tracks, or just change it for one track. Same track shift, you can shift tracks forward and backward. You can choose the track length, you choose the first and the third and the last step, and your track will be here trapped. Then, random, you can randomize everything. You can do fill-ins like ta 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 ta. Live recording, there are different ways. You can record gates. Like, you can record, or you can record CVs. You choose the track and then you can press the notes here. And you have free play. It's like a small piano that you can play notes. You can mute. The channels, you can. This is a new feature that we have just released. It's a stepped LFO, so you can use the gate output for a drum module, and the CV output you can use it for an LFO. That you have different types of shapes, and the good thing about that LFO that you can change the time, and this time is synced. You can decide that the LFO will last one pattern, or one pattern and one step. So this is a good way to have your LFOs controlled. Then, auxiliary channel, you can freeze and revert. This is a good thing for performance. For example, you have this pattern that you want to take a snapshot. You freeze it. You freeze it. And then you start to change things. And when you want, you recall that freeze pattern and you go back to the pattern that you have. Many people use this for performance, and because it's a good way to improvise, but going back to the safe place. Then, well, you can... All the information is stored in the SD card. You can store up to 5 65,000 patterns, so it's a lot, and they are structured in projects. Also, you have two CV outputs. These CV outputs can be assigned to most of the parameters, so with this CV output you can control the CV probability, and with this CV input you can control, for example, the track shift and move all the sequence. What else? Well, this, as I told you, this is the new silver panel. We also think in an expansion, first of all, a standalone unit that will have MIDI in and MIDI out, and we also will have a MIDI expansion for this Eloquencer that will probably have MIDI in and MIDI out, and some extra buttons for auxiliary functions. And well, that's all. Many thanks. Just to remember, the things that people most like from this sequencer is that it's really very useful and very easy to use. People start to work with it without reading the manual, and for them it's very easy to use it. And well, that's all. Many thanks for listening. Thank you. I'm a disaster doing
that. That was very good. That was very good.
Very professional. No.